Welcome to the first Zodcast video. In this video, I'll be going over base building and how to base build at the Town Hall 9 level to protect against a 3-star, so anti-3-star bases. There'll be very little production value. It's just going to be me talking unedited and everything because I don't have time to go through all that other stuff. So this will just be me telling you what I know or what I think. This isn't the right way to do it, it's just how I've done it. So let's get started. First, Clan Castle. You want to make sure that's not an easy lure, and that this ring right here is on the outside of, or is on the inside of the bases. Like right here, it kind of looks like it's almost outside of the Archer Tower, but it's not, because the loons and the hogs will sit outside of it. Also, something else you kind of want to pay attention to is when you send in, like, if someone were to send in a hog, it would come in here, then it would path either over here or over here. It wouldn't path inside of the Clan Castle radius. That's something else you want to pay attention to if you can do. I'm not going to spend much time on it because I think it's something everyone should already know. The Queen. Now this is something that I feel more people don't know about, so I'll go into a little bit more depth. You want to protect your queen because she's the most important defense to protect against hog attacks or Laloon, Shattered Laloon, all those things. They'll always need to take out the queen first, so you want to make her very hard to get to. First thing I like to make sure of is that her jump radius, so she'll jump outside to about here-ish, I think, give or take. And the important thing to make sure of is that this compartment right here, this one, and this one. These are all on the outside. As you can see, I failed at Arts and Craft. So I'm going to make sure that she won't jump into any of these compartments with blue in them. And that's because you can easily send in some wall breakers or jump in the king, and you most likely won't need a golem if your king is high enough. So you want them to use at least one golem when going after your queen. And the way you do that is put her farther in, make sure she doesn't jump out to this compartment on the outside. Something else I like to do is I find the closest half of the base. So she's on this half of the base. So anywhere over here, I'll find the weakest place that they can go in at, and I will put down the king. And so I identified the weakest spot over here because you don't have very much a point defense. You've got this cannon here, you've got this archer that will come over a little bit, this expo, but that's not very much DPS. So to slow down the king and queen golems or whatever they bring in, I put the king right here. And the king is just a tank, another high DPS troop, or high HP troop that they'll have to eat through. At the same time, the queen will be back here shooting, helping out. So, next thing is the town hall. I like to put the town hall on the opposite side of the king, just because they can come in this way with a shattered and try to take out my queen, because my queen will come out to over here. So, I mean, it's the same thing. You have to get through this compartment and then a jumper wall breaker to get into another compartment. And since the king's over here, the town hall is just a high HP building, much like the king acts like one. So, and then storages. I see very few people actually using the storages what I think is correctly. And you'll see I have a bunch lined up right here. Terrible color, you can barely see it. And a bunch lined up right here. And then one over here. So what I like to do with the storages is we've got this part of the base. Let me get another color. This part of the base kind of taken away because the town hall's right there. I got this kind of taken away because I got the king right there. Not taken away, just kind of. It's hard to get through. And so if they were going to take a shattered and want to take out the queen and two air defenses, or hog attack, I'm talking about, this is when people take shattered, they more likely will be taking a Golaloon, so they'll try to take out two air defenses and your queen. So the easiest way to do this is to come from a broadside this way or this way, because I've got my air defenses right here, so it's much easier to get to. And for them to get both air defenses, usually it's the queen that takes out both air defenses. She'd have to eat through this, and maybe this before she'll actually target the second air defense, because this one might be taken out by a golem or a king. But for her to transition to one to another, she's got to go through four high health buildings. Same thing over here, she's going to have to go through three of them. And this all while the clan castle's coming out, you got the queen shooting at the king and the golem and everything. So that's what I like to do for my queen. Next thing we'll talk about, one more thing. Compartment size. As you can see, this compartment right here is 4 deep. So enough to fit a double giant bomb. You want all your compartments to be at least 4 deep. It gives the chance to have a double giant bomb location. And also, if it's only 3 deep, so let's quickly change this. All of a sudden, you can put a jump right here, which bridges the outside with this compartment right here, and you no longer need to, or your queen is now basically on the outside compartment, because you just bridge that right there, and so the king will just come right up there and kill her straight away. So you want to make sure that all your compartments are at least 4 deep. Fix my base real quick. Did I lose one? There's my wall. Okay. I'm on blue stacks, and it's not very user friendly because I don't have a touch screen. Okay. Continuing on. Air defenses. So what I like to do with my air defenses is I like to have the radius overlapping with at least two other ones. And so you can see that this one's overlapping two. This one's overlapping two other ones. So everything, this one is actually overlapping three, I think. Yep, it is. And there. So all the radiuses are really close to each other. And so when, let's say they send in Lava Hound from here and here, they'll be sitting over top of this and over top of this. This will be helping out here. This will be helping out here, most likely. Or if you're lucky, this will help here. This will help here. And these hounds right here will just absolutely be fried. So next thing you want to do for your air defenses is the air defenses that are least likely to be attacked in a shattered attack. You want to have two air bombs on, and what this does is I think it does about 3,200 damage to each lava hound. If they attack from this side, all of a sudden they hit two bombs, and then they've either got three or two air defenses hitting on them. They don't last very long. I've had Town Hall 10 attack this setup, and the Lava Hounds were gone in about a minute. four and five of them. So another thing you want to do for the air defense, I generally don't like them being on the outside compartment. However, I have built a base that's been successful where it's on the outside like this. But since it's not the first thing that can be attacked, and usually there's a little bit more space here and you can put a spring trap so hogs can't come in and get it. But I have built bases. You just want to make sure that an air defense is never on the outside like this where it can be attacked straight away. And if you do, you want to make sure you put some spring traps or something just to kind of make sure that's not a very easy hog kill. So, rebuilding my base. Next thing I will talk about is Teslas in relation to the air defenses. So, what I like to do to protect against low lunar attacks is I will stack the Teslas kind of like this. This isn't my exact setup, but okay. So something like this, where if they bring in a hound from right here again, they all of a sudden have to deal with those two air bombs hitting. They've got to deal with three air defenses, and they've got to deal with another 400 damage coming from the Teslas. So it's just something else that can quickly kill those hounds. And what I actually think works better, where can I put this sucker, is I think doubling them up like this on one air defense that has the double black bombs, or the double SAMs, and then this one right here. So doubling up the Teslas with the doubling of the air mines. It just ensures that those hounds go down just that much quicker. Okay, I think that's it. So let's start talking about double giant bomb locations. And this is something that I feel like a lot of people don't completely understand. What makes a good double giant bomb location. So right here, here, or here, 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 and here. These are all the possible locations. I think we all know that sending a hound here, pop this one, and you mitigate that. So that's not a very good double giant bomb location. So we'll take this one off the map. Now, this one right here, and this one right here. Alright, I think a better example would be talking about this one over here first. So, this double giant bomb location right here. It's in the core. You have an easy path from this to over here. But what I feel like a lot of people don't understand is that's not a good double giant bomb location, because it can be pre-triggered even though it's in the core. Because let's say you have a bunch of hounds, or sorry, hogs that come in from here and this way and move this way throughout the base, come across here, and they're sitting at this expo right here. So at this point in time, you'll have your hogs kind of, they'll be spread out on this side. And let's cut this in half. So every hog on this side will travel this way. Every hog on this side will travel this way. And all of a sudden, you've got hogs tagging this side. And if you're lucky, they might spread around here. But if they don't spread along this side right here, you'll never have the possibility of popping this double giant bomb location. You can they'll pop this one, but this one will be untriggered until they kill this defense and path over this way, or these hogs come over here. And if they set a heal down, they can heal through that, and you just wasted two double giant bombs. So, location. So, same thing with this one right here. And right here. The one that goes that way, you can. Same thing. You'll have hounds come this way. You most likely won't get hounds or hogs that will attack this backside, so you'll have them line up right here. So this one right here will never be triggered. So let's talk about the one that would be right here. If someone were to send in a bunch of hogs and they go that way, and then they send a couple hogs and they go that way, send in a couple and they'll go straight in and they'll pop this one. So that double giant bomb location is out. Same thing here, and here, and here. These are the best locations. They send in hogs at this right here. They're gonna path over here, or over here. Because they're on the outside, it's so much easier for them to travel right or left rather than inside. So that's a valid double giant bomb location. However, when you look at where the queen is positioned, you most likely have someone come in with a cold-blooded from this direction or from this direction, at which point the golem is going to get into this compartment and most likely pop these double giant bomb locations. So this is why I would never use that one right there. So it's down to these two. And these are good locations because for them to get inside, they would have to send in a couple of hogs here, a couple of hogs here, and they would want them to path that way, and you'd want these ones to path over this way, but not too early, and then send in a couple more to finally to kill that, and then to go inside, at which point that's just, I'm going to take my chance of someone completely screwing that up over, you know, anything else. So, okay, same thing with over here. You're going to want to have someone take out this building, send it in there, and then they'd have to take out here and here so they converge here and then come in. And even then, you might, the hogs might bunch up over here and never touch this until they find their path over. So, I could go into more about double giant bombs, but it's getting long-winded, and I think you guys get the idea. So, now let's talk about wizard towers. You want to make sure that the wizard tower's radiuses are not within the air defenses, and that's because when people send in hound attack, the loons will clump up, and one wizard tower can do 300 damage to a group of five loons, because I think they do about 60 damage. 60 times 5 equals 300, and so you're not getting that much DPS out of any other defense except for air defenses, and those are being occupied by the hounds. So make sure that your wizard towers are not being occupied by those air defenses. And I know that's very difficult, kind of leaves them to be on the outside. You really don't want them to be on the outside. But no base is perfect, so. One last thing I will talk about is this new leaf blower. So what this does is basically will take away a side that someone can come in on for a lava hound attack. So let's say I have it right here. Common sense says you probably want it here, but that's wrong. Because you want it to this. You want to be protecting certain defenses. And so what this does is it forces them to come in from the side. And if that allows you to stack up like this, just kind of like how I said earlier, and all of a sudden they'll be sending in their hounds, and they'll, by the time they put down their rages and the balloons kill those air defenses and stuff, so the hounds are transitioning, they'll most likely pop. And then, since there's nothing to tank, you've got this expo that'll turn around and just take care of all the pups, which is, almost, I think, a one-shot killer almost. So that's how I would use this leaf blower, is I would put it on, aiming on the far side of the base. And make sure you're protecting your important defenses. So at Town Hall 10, you want to protect a air defense, at least two air defenses, and then most likely an expo if you can. So I think that kind of concludes everything about base building. There's more, but it's, like I said, it's getting long-winded. Oh, one last thing. Skelly traps. Put them down. Make sure they're set to air. Red bombs. Try not to put them in the path of the lava hounds. Oh, I lied. One more thing. Spring traps, I see people use them incorrectly all the time. Spring traps should be placed in locations where hogs will path over. This, to me, it seems very simple and obvious, but some people don't, so I make sure everyone knows that. So they can send three hogs flying at a time. So, yep, there you have it. That's all I got for now.